What is it about the story of these two men that transcends pure sport?
Oh, it's just the psychology of tennis. It's intense. And these guys in the 80s were, or the 70s were like the first rock stars of tennis. So it was very fun to go back to those days and do a movie about it.
Talk about the process of becoming a tennis player overnight.
I think the physical part was the key into the role, because it made me feel like an athlete, and made you stronger, so it gives you focus.
And obviously the chemistry between these two men was electric. Can you talk about your chemistry with Shia?
Should I talk about it? Yeah. We had a very good relationship working, and we trained together, learned the duels, and worked hard.
Now there must be some rivalry off camera playing tennis players, right? Because he put in 2 hours a week, and you put 15 hours a week. That's what he said.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that was when he was in LA. But when we met in Prague, we played all the time. Just played a lot of tennis, and then I read everything and I looked at everything I could find about Bjorn Borg.
Do you feel you understand the relationship between Borg and McEnroe better now after making this film?
Yeah, I think so. I think you talk about that they're different characters, and they're so different, ice and fire, but I think they're very similar in a way. They both want to win and wanted to be the best in the world. And
did you actually get to meet them?
I've met Bjorn Borg.
Oh,
yeah,
really? And
he was a very nice guy, and he liked the movie.
Oh, you fall in love with tennis?
Sorry?
Did you fall in love with tennis?
Yeah, I love it.